Hi there. So now we are focusing in audio routing within the digital audio workstations, and we have already looked in the previous videos how to do audio configuration for your digital audio workstations. In this video, we will look into Universal Audio Luna and see how to do audio routing in Luna specifically for parallel processing, sidechaining, and bus mixes and submixes, as someone might say. So let's get going with Luna and see how it's done over there. Okay, so let's start with the Universal Audio Luna and audio processing, and see how it supports your workflow when it comes to the audio routing. And we have discussed about the basic concepts, but now we will take the a bit more advanced routing activities like sidechaining, parallel processing, and submixing. So yeah, let's start with fact that we create two audio tracks, and we'll create them stereo, and we'll create two of them, and then at this time we don't need to have any console or tape, so we just take a vanilla audio tracks. This we could actually name as audio, and then this we could basically then name as kick, and that's it. So now we have two tracks, and I'll bring some audio here. So let's bring in audio file, and then of course if I now play, it's vanilla, and there is nothing extra in it. It's just basically the audio goes directly from you know, from the track to the main output, and nothing special in the processing. But then if I would like to now add a bus, then I go here and I add a bus. And I could use these summings and all that stuff if I want, but I select none, no summing either. And I could go and name this, for example, a reverb. So I go and say that this is the reverb. And now I have a reverb channel that is independent, and then of course I would need to add a reverb. Let's add a Valhalla reverb into it. And now I have that added, so I'm happy with that one. So that's my effect. And then if I would like to now do a parallel processing within Luna, then I go into the send, and I send it into the reverb, and then I just say how much. And then if I play, you can hear it, and then when I mute it, you basically don't hear it. So that's how you do, in a simple way, you do parallel processing, and you can of course add these sends quite a few, depending on what your needs are. But this is basically the basic parallel processing. And then we could discuss about submixing or bus mixing. So for that we could basically take also and have a kick in here. And let's bring the kick here. And then now both of these tracks are going individually to main. So so if I look here, you can see that that's the kick and the audio, they all go into main. Let's take them a bit down so that it's not that loud, but you can still hear them. So yeah, still both are going into main, but then how you basically then do a bus processing is that you select the both tracks, and then you can go and create a bus. And when you say that, you know, let's just give it a name as a bus. So when I say now create, it will create a bus, and then you can see that this that I had selected, the audio and kick, both gets now routed, the output gets routed into the bus. And now I could apply any effects into the bus and they would apply to both of those kick and audio. Also now they are behind one fader. So if I play, I still hear the reverb, but if I take that down as well, you hear nothing. Because basically both of the kick and piano, they go into the bus, and then extra the piano goes to reverb. Now I just hear the reverb, but this is basically now so-called kind of a mix bus or bus processing or submixing, so that you can apply effects into this bus, and then that will apply, you know, for example, you apply a compressor and it will apply the compressor for both audio and kick. And that's basically, that's the way you work with that one. But then one extra area that we haven't yet touched, and I'll just remove this one, is kind of sidechaining. And how to do the sidechaining in Luna is that let's go and take the Pro C as we have used it elsewhere as well. And in Luna, when you do sidechaining, you basically need to go over here into the utility section, and then from here or here you can basically select that assign a sidechain. So currently there is none, but then you can go and say that you assign a kick into the sidechain, and then you could also say that, you know, that you assign this into the Pro C. So now you have assigned that the sidechain input that is coming in is assigned to a kick, and then on top of that the sidechain is going into a FabFilter Pro Q, Pro C. And let's take the external input as a external sidechain into use, and we'll bring threshold drastically down, so you see that when the signal from the kick comes in, how drastically it will suppress the audio signal in the audio channel. And now when you play, you start to see that basically taking a place. And from here you can of course then tune the level of an amount of how much sidechain signal is coming in into this channel. So that's how the sidechaining works in Luna. And then that's pretty much it. It kind of concludes the main things, like regarding on the advanced routing techniques, sidechaining, parallel processing, and submixing. And these techniques can be applied quite easily and nicely in Luna, so it's quite easy to set up as others as well, and quite straightforward from that respect. Alrighty, that was Universal Audio Luna, and now we have two more to go. Next we will jump into Cubase and see how the audio routing is done in Cubase. So remember to subscribe for the channel for more great content. Thanks for watching. Bye now.